What's up, guys, man? It's all trending on social media. President Muhammadu Buhari's, tweet actually deleted by, Twitter, and that some people are condemning Twitter for that, while some other persons are saying, yes, Mr. President, you need to be guided in your statement because, most of the statements you've been making in recent time, kind of spells hate, and that is not actually healthy for Nigeria right now. We need something that is unifying, not something that is dividing at this particular time. I have something on Davido. Davido album did 427 million streams in 5 months. And then Wizkid did about 532.8 million streams in 7 months, and that is actually huge right now, and some people are just excited and happy about that. I think that is a kudos to Davido. But Mr. President has been on the lips of everybody. Everybody is talking about it. Recently something happened, and then it's all interesting to actually talk about. But the Attorney General of the Federation, Malami, asked Buhari to suspend Nigeria constitution, declare martial law, and that is what is being condemned across social media platforms. Before I jump right in, I want you guys to kindly subscribe to my YouTube channel. Hit the subscribe button below and the bell notification icon to always get notifications each time I upload my videos. But if already subscribed, thank you for subscribing. Make sure you share my videos across social media platforms so that others will get to see what is trending and what we are talking about on social media. All right, now, celebration across social media fans, musical fans, as Davido's album, a Better Time album, actually did 427.7 million streams on streaming platforms. And Why Made in Lagos album of Wizkid did about 532.8 million streams in 7 months, and that is actually being celebrated right now. I think Davido, Wizkid and Burna Boy, they are the biggest artists in Nigeria right now. That is something you need to understand, and that is why most people find it like, man, easy to compare Davido, Burna Boy, or Wizkid at a point in time. But I think we need to actually celebrate our own. That is one thing I keep saying, and we should find a way to bringing them together to making a song for us, which will become the one of the biggest song from Africa. Yes, Twitter deletes Buhari's genocide tweet after condemnation by Nigerians. That is actually trending. When he made that tweet on social media, on Twitter, a lot of people did retweet that, condemning that, and it was deleted later by Twitter. According to what Mr. President tweeted, he said, many of those misbehaving today are too young to be aware of the destruction and loss of lives that occurred during the Nigerian Civil War. Those of us in the field for 30 months who went through the war, we treat them in the language they understand. And that has sparked a lot of reactions so far. Let's watch most of the reactions so that you get to understand what people are saying about that.
I think those that are misbehaving, they were either too young, they didn't know what happened. But for those of us who went through all these things, we can't understand. So we treat them in the language they understand.
I mean, I heard the bit on the attacks on INEC offices and infrastructure, and I think I can understand the frustrations all over the country with these attacks on government installations. But, and when he was speaking specifically about the Civil War, First of all, I mean, I think we need to know who exactly is behind these attacks. But to the extent he started speaking about the civil war, he was right up to the point where he was saying that some of the separatists, people who were demanding secession and so on, and maybe being a bit aggressive about it, were people who had not seen the war. I saw the war. I was a young child, and war is terrible. I want to tell you, war is terrible. It may sound romantic, but it is not in reality. And therefore, we must avoid conflict, armed conflict, and civil war in this country and destruction. But to the point he then said, we will treat them in the language they understand. I did not think that that was the kind of statement he should have made as the president of the country.
My name is Aisha Somtochukwu Yusufu. I am Igbo. Any threat to the Igbo people is a threat to me. Any attack on the Igbo people is an attack on me. Any malignment of the Igbo people is a malignment to me. We are all Nigerians, and no Nigerian is more Nigerian than any Nigerian. And the government must ensure that it deploys its resources and it deploys its apparatus equally to every section of this country. I totally condemn the tweets from the president, where the president is threatening the Igbo people. He is threatening them with what happened in 1967. What happened in 1967 was a genocide, a crime against humanity, and it must never, ever, ever be allowed to happen again. Not only must it never, ever be allowed to happen again, Nigeria must apologize for that crime against humanity. And for a president to come out today and use 1967 as a yardstick to threaten people with what happened then, with the 30 months of gruesomeness, with the 30 months of heinousness, with the 30 months of atrocities that were meted out on human beings, on fellow brothers and sisters, on children in this country. It's inhumane, it's insensitive, it is callous, and it's unspeakable. And I, Aisha Somtochukwu Yusufu, I am saying today, I am repeating today, that I am Igbo. And any attack on Igbo people is an attack on me. No Nigerian is more Nigerian than any Nigerian. And this country belongs to all of us. And nobody will denigrate anyone of us from being fully Nigeria.
Guys, what do you feel about this? I need that in the comment section, because it is an issue of discussion right now. It's a topic of discussion. A lot of people are now condemning Mr. President based on the tweet and saying that, why would you hate a particular set of people? You know, that is the Igbo. The Igbos are not happy right now. And also looking at what is happening around the country, a lot of political assassination going on, and the young people are being used for this, and that is what some people are talking about. If you had provided a job for, you know, young people, I think this would have been like, you know, something you know, we should be like hearing from a distance. But this is happening within the society. That is what I need to actually say at this point in time. But Mr. President, you didn't do well to have said what you said on social media. Thank God Twitter deleted it, and you may be receiving some kind of sanction. And Lai Mohammed came out to actually say a lot of things, and I don't give him attention at all, because he needs to understand that a particular guideline governs you know, Twitter, social media, you know, platforms and the rest, and you have to play to that guideline. That is something you need to understand, Lai Mohammed.
So we will treat them in the language they understand.
In a secret memo, Attorney General of the Federation, Malami, asked Buhari to suspend Nigerian constitution, declare martial law. According to a report, Mr. Malami said that president should issue instruments of emergency, publish them in the Federal Gazette. Senate President Ahmed Lawan and Speaker Femi Bajamila will be informed about the decision ahead of implementation, he added. In the early pages of the document, Mr. Malamin cited widespread acts of insecurity, blamed prominent separatist agitators like Sunday Igbo and Nnamdi Kanu for fueling the portrayed crisis that has enveloped the country and aggravated social and economic conditions of Nigerians. The memo was endorsed to President by the National Security Advisor Babagana Mungunu and administration of officials on how to proceed with the advice. That is actually disturbing. Yes, another report went ahead to say that Attorney General of the Federation Abubakar Malami has already written lengthy legal advice to the Nigerian president, urging him to move swiftly to suspend the fundamental rights of all Nigerians as guaranteed under the chapter 4 of the constitution. In the 8-page secret memo dated May 4, 2021, Mr. Malami told Mr. Buhari that insecurity across Nigeria has reached a level that could no longer be checked by existing democratic techniques, saying only a state of emergency promulgated by the president can help the country to tranquility. The essence of declaration is to allow for suspension of constitution and legal bureaucratic bottleneck pertaining to matters of national security, with particular regards to fundamental rights guaranteed under chapter 4 of the 99 constitution, and process and procedures relating to the procurement, among others, Attorney General said. Man, this is quite disturbing, and it's like plunging Nigeria into further crisis. That is what I believe about that. But I will bring more news to you about this, because we don't want to tolerate this for now. What do you have to say about this recent development? Do you believe that yes, this is going to augur well, or do you believe that a lot of kind of criminal politicians are going to abuse this kind of a martial law? What do you have to say about that? Put that in the comment section until I come right back with a lot of enthusiastic news and interesting stories to actually discuss about. Right now, I'm leaving the office because I slept over at the office just to finish up some kind of assignments.